My name is Patrick Walker. This will be my fourth or fifth year in Texas coaching. I went to a high school in the Chicago suburbs, Glenbard East High School, what would be a bigger high school in Texas in A-Day.
What do you remember from your senior year of football?
It was a tougher year, but the things that I remember the most are just, you know, being with my best friends, my teammates that I worked with all offseason, being around those guys, the little things, the moments that definitely, if I had to go back, I wish I would have soaked in more. That kind of stuff, when you're going through two-a-days and when you're lifting in the offseason and you're building that camaraderie, that's a special thing. And senior year goes by so fast that that's the stuff that I miss. And I was fortunate enough to move on to the next level and play and have another senior year, but not everyone gets those opportunities. I would like the seniors right now to remember the little things that just go unnoticed. Preparation before practice or during practice, when you're not feeling good, those days, they just go by so fast, and I just want them to be able to remember the looks, the smells, the being around their teammates in the locker room. The locker room is such a special place, and being around your brothers, it's just, there's nothing like it. For the incoming freshmen, be a sponge and trust the process. When freshmen come in, they're not getting the playing time they expect, or they're not where they expect to be right away. And what we're trying to do is build you for long term. We're not trying to microwave it. We're trying to teach you. We're trying to get you set up for the future. And that's what we're always building towards. So be a sponge, soak everything in from your coaches. All right, take every single thing in, write it down if you have to. Do what you have to do to do those things, and then you'll put yourself in a position where you want to be later on in your high school football career, I promise you. And work as hard as you can every single day. We always say get from point A to point B as fast as you can, as hard as you can, and you'll be all right. So be a sponge, soak everything in. The coaches are here to help you.
Tyson Neighbors, number 5, running back, free safety, and outside linebacker. I've been playing football for about 13 years, since I was around 4 years old. Some of the best advice I've been given is probably just to always work hard. My dad was always on me ever since I was little to work hard every single day, and he always would tell me days I would try to take off just that someone else out there is working harder than you. And personally, I don't want nobody else to work harder than me. I would be prided in the fact that I work harder than everybody else to up my game.
Is football your primary sport?
I'd say I have two primary sports. So I'd say football and baseball are kind of equal, tied with each other. So.
Have you been playing baseball for just as long?
I've actually played baseball for a little bit longer. I played since I was 3.
Have you started preparing for college?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I recently committed to Kansas State University to play baseball and hopefully some football too.
What advice would you give to younger athletes to keep it all balanced?
Really just stay on top of your grades. Me personally, that's my number one priority, is to be on top of my grades, because if you're not on top of your grades, it don't matter how good you are on the football field or baseball field, whatever sport you're playing, you're not gonna be able to play it.
Parker Simpson, number 8. And I've been playing football for about 5 years now.
Is football your primary sport?
No. I'd say baseball is my primary sport, but I play all three, football, basketball, and baseball.
Classify baseball as your primary.
Because I've been playing baseball my whole life, been playing summer leagues, and I'm trying to get recruited for baseball right now.
Well, have you started preparing for college?
Yeah, I've been looking at some schools. I filled out my FAFSA and everything, and I'm just trying to get prepared to apply and everything.
What are your top three picks right now?
Right now, it'd be Embry-Riddle. It's in Florida, and ULM, Louisiana Monroe, and then the University of Houston.
What's attracting you to the out-of-state schools?
They have my degree program, and I take that very seriously, so that's very important.
Okay, what are you planning on majoring in?
Aviation or meteorology.
What advice would you give to younger athletes?
I say just stay the course. You know, times are going to be hard. I think we've all been through it. But just being prepared and being tough and getting through everything, it makes you a better person along the way. The best advice I've given is from my dad. He always tells me to just keep grinding. You know, some days are tougher than others. You know, might have a bad day at school, but it doesn't matter. You got to get better.
My name is Brendan Lira, and I've been playing football for 4 years. I just kind of want the senior class to know that it's been great and it's been fun having everybody as classmates. And also for the upcoming freshmen, stay true to who you are. Don't let anybody change you. Work hard, be coachable, and just do your best to be successful.
I want the class of 2020 to remember the way that we've changed our school spirit and our community involvement, especially in these past 2 years. Ms. O and Coach Crane have played a big role in that, but it's also been a big thing in our class, and I could tell how everybody's changed and gotten really involved. I want the class of 2024 to know that time goes by fast, and I know people say that all the time. They're like, oh, it's gonna go by fast. You're gonna be a senior before you know it, but you really will. And it really will be your last home football game or your last, any of your last. There's lots of them, and it will come before you know it.
I want the class of 2020 to remember all of the fun and carefree moments throughout our high school career, and also how big of an impact we played in the culture change of Caddo Mills, and how we were here for all of the changes and everything good that's coming, because Caddo is gonna be something. I want the class of 2024 to know that one day you're starting off first day of freshman year, and next you know you're having your senior night for the last time at Ed Locker Stadium. And also, always stay true to yourself, because that's what really matters, and people are going to like you for you. So always stay true.
Hi, I'm Cassidy Bramlett, and I've been dancing for years. My biggest inspiration is probably definitely my friends and family. I go to look for people for advice all the time, because I cannot make my own decisions to save my life. So I definitely go to everybody I can. My friends, the officers, my fellow officers for previous years and this year, they always help me with what to do and anything like that, and definitely my directors and my parents. I want the class of 2020 to remember all of the memories they have made throughout high school. Remember your friends, remember where you came from. So if you definitely move off to bigger cities, definitely don't forget your roots. I want the class of 2024 to know, definitely get involved in high school. That is your main thing. Get involved, because it'll be a lot easier, a lot more fun. You'll make new friends, meet new people.
My name is Reese Payne, I'm number 33, and I've played football for Caddo Mills for 6 years. I feel like lately one of my inspirations that has come about has been our whole coaching staff this year. I feel like they've brought about a lot of positivity and just a lot of fight and will to our team, and has fired us up through the season. It's just helped us, just a lot of change has helped us have a great season, and I think they're just a bunch of great guys, so I think they're my inspiration this year. I would like the class of 2020 to remember the culture change we've had here in Caddo this year, and all of the fun times we've had together and the great season we've had. I would like the incoming class of 2024 to know that Caddo Mills has always been a team with fight, and I feel like that y'all need to carry it on, and it needs to be an ongoing thing to have the team with the most fight around this area.
Thank you, Emil, number 3, class of 2021.
So we play Spring Hill this week, and I hope to see everybody there, and we're going to be bringing the fight to them, and we're just going to be bringing it this week, so hopefully we'll see everybody there, and hopefully y'all will have the fire up in the stands and be getting us fired up throughout the game.
Can I say that?
Whatever you want to do.
Well, let's like keep saying a couple. Is there going to be bloopers in this? Go Foxes. Hey, why'd I go like that? Wait. Sweating out. Okay. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, thank y'all for watching. Please like and subscribe. Go Foxes!